Hi everyone, I'm Stegar and today I'm going to show you how to set up time traffic lights at a diamond interchange in City Skylines. Like the two other tutorials I've done on time traffic lights, this requires the Traffic Manager President Edition mod. So let's get started. We first open up the Traffic Manager menu and select the second option in on the bottom row, which is time traffic lights. We need to select two nodes for this one. Just simply click on each node and it should select both of them. Press the set up time traffic lights button and add the first step, which is allowing all the ways to go straight through. So we want to allow this one to be green, change this second one in the middle here to go through on green, just the straight option though, and do a similar thing on the other side, straight through, and the far one is green again. And for this one, I was messing around earlier with the timing. I've selected 15 seconds as the maximum time for this one, and unlike my other tutorials where I did 1 second, this one will have a 3 second minimum time just to allow the traffic to start flowing before it clocks through the next traffic phase. And now, adding the second step, we change this light that's coming into the interchange to red and allow left turns on this inside lane here, and do the same on the other side by allowing left turns and putting this other way to red so that they're not interfering. At that step, we're leaving the timing the same, and the final step is simply to allow the cars from the highway to actually come into the road. Disable both of these now, enable this one, and then do a similar thing on the other side by disabling these and enabling this one. So that is for the traffic anyway. We haven't really touched on pedestrians yet because there's still going to be some cars doing funky things and we don't want that. So where this is green, we now want to change this light to manual, and that should disable and then disable the crossings there, and do the same on the other side, change that to manual, and save this step again. This was the first one that I went into, and I think we need to do the same for the second step. No, that's disabled automatically, so it should be fine. And actually the third step, we want to enable it because the car's coming from this road, even though the game thinks they're going to go through there. We don't want that, so we can allow this and do the same on the other side. And for now, we can start the traffic lights, and before we actually start the simulation, we need to check that all the lanes are connected to the right place. Simply pick the lane connector, click on this first node here. On the cars coming into the intersection, we only want them to turn left or right. So just select all these lanes. If you want to allow them to do U-turns and go back onto the highway, you can select this inside one here. And if you don't, then just don't select it. And for this direction, you just want to allow them to go straight through. These ones should be fine. It's mainly just this one coming into the intersection that we need to change, as long as you've got the lanes added up correctly in the first place. So I'll just go through it anyway. This one can go straight through. We won't allow them to switch lanes here, so that one can go straight through. That one is turning left, and this other one can go right or straight through, and this other lane can go to both the lanes and straight through, which will then allow for it to turn to the left up here or go straight through, and this other lane goes straight through too. This on-ramp again, we can allow it to come into the intersection going on the inside, and again, if you want to let it do U-turns, click here, but if you don't, then don't select that one. And turn right too onto both lanes. And the final option is again just allowing these cars to go straight through onto both these lanes and turning right or going straight through. So that is the basic setup for a diamond interchange. And for a more complicated one, I'll show you what to do in just a second. So for the second, slightly more complicated approach to the diamond interchange, we are going to use the same lane setup that we used in the first one, which I just did a few seconds ago. And we're going to set up time traffic lights to again use both of these nodes and set up time traffic lights. The first option that we're going to add is for this one to go straight through, turning that to green, coming off the on-ramp here. We're going to leave the time at 3 seconds minimum and 15 seconds maximum. You can adjust this if you think it needs to be higher or lower. And because these cars are turning left and right, we can enable this pedestrian crossing because they won't be driving straight through the interchange, otherwise there's no point in having it. And so that is now green, and we come to here, and for the sake of what we're about to do in the future steps, we're going to change this light here to going straight through and turning left, and then change this light here to straight through and going left as well. And for this light here on the other side, we're going to allow it to be green on both of these and add that step. And the second step, we're only going to change this to be going straight through only, and changing this to being green. And then because these cars can then turn into here, we want to disable this, and then there won't be pedestrians going across here. And add this step. The next step, we're just going to focus on this side, and we want to turn this off and allow these to go straight through and turning left, and disabling this again so that when the cars turn they don't change or anything. And add this. And the fourth step is pretty much the same setup as the first step, but just rotated 180 degrees around. We want to change this step over here. We want to disable both of these lights, allow this on-ramp to come through into the intersection, and then enable this pedestrian crossing. So we add that step. The timing's all still the same, 3 seconds for each, 15 seconds max. Adding the fifth step, which is keeping this the same and just changing this turn to then allow this way to go straight through. We add that step, and the final step is changing this side again and disabling this and allowing straight through and left turns. And this is all set up and correctly now. That is disabled so that when they turn, the pedestrians aren't going through. And this side is just staying the same. So that's a slightly more complicated setup, but you can see here that they start flowing through, and as they get through they start to turn, and then when these cars go through they can go straight or they can turn, and it just flows smoothly. There's not much traffic backed up here at the moment apart from on this on-ramp, so it should just start flowing nice and smoothly. And by allowing 3 seconds, it just allows these cars time to get between here and here before it starts changing through all the different light phases. And this is a better option but slightly more complicated and requires a bit of fine-tuning with the timing to get it to work right in your cities. If you found this tutorial helpful, then leave a like so that YouTube promotes it to other people. And if you want to see more tutorials, then comment in the comment section what you want to see me do, and I'll try and do it depending on what it is. Thank you for watching, and goodbye.